Hi there, welcome to QA Box Let's Test. If you have not already subscribed to this channel, kindly do so. And if you like the video, give them the thumbs up. All right, in part 31 of this video series, we talked about the asynchronous nature of JavaScript. So in this video, we are going to take that concept further and we are going to start with callback, then we'll cover promises into JavaScript, and finally async and await keyword. All right, so before we jump on to the code part, let's understand what is synchronous and what is asynchronous. So let's imagine this is a restaurant and C1 and C2 are two customers, and here's the kitchen. All right, so let's imagine now this is the waiter. So waiter comes to customer one, all right, takes the order, goes to the kitchen, informs the kitchen, and sits there until the order is processed. Once the order is processed, it comes to C1 with the order. So that's called as synchronous nature. Now what is asynchronous? So again, this waiter comes to C1, customer 1, takes the order, informs kitchen, goes to customer 2, takes the order, informs the kitchen again. If the order is processed for customer 1, kitchen will inform this waiter. Waiter will pick the food and serve it to customer 1, goes back to the kitchen again. Once the food is processed for customer 2, collect that food and serve customer 2. So the single waiter is serving multiple clients. As we know, as we talked about in part 31, that JavaScript engine is a single threaded engine. So this single thread is working asynchronously to serve multiple requests simultaneously. So it is not holding customer 2 from ordering the food, right, until this C1 orders is processed, right? That's asynchronous. All right, so let's move on to the code part. And what we are going to do is, so this is the index page, right? And herein I'm going to cover all the three concepts. So the first one is callback, and what we are going to do in callback is we have to assume it like, you know, we are getting the response back from the server itself. So this is the data, all right? And now let's write some functions to implement this. Okay, so function get animals, and then this function, and because we have to mimic the server response type setup, so we are going to use set timeout, and the first argument is a callback function. Okay, so we are going to use fat arrow syntax in here. And the second argument is the timeout. So we are going to run this function after 1000 milliseconds or 1 second. Okay. So now here what we are going to do is we are going to say let output is equal to empty string. And then what we are going to do is we are going to say animals dot for each. Okay. And the first argument of this is again a callback function. So what we are going to do is animal, and we are going to use this, and then output is equal to, so we are going to append the item from this array to output string. And what we are going to do is we are going to use string literal syntax, and we are going to say li, and then dollar sign, let's say I want to read animal.type. Okay, then I would like to do a hyphen, and I would like to do the animal.example. Okay, so, and then let me close the li tag, which is going to be li. All right, so this is how we are going to concatenate, and then once this for each is done, we are going to say document dot body dot inner HTML is equal to output. That's what we are going to do in here. Okay, so that's our get animal function. Now let us write one function which is post animal. So let's write that function post animal. We are going to post a new animal from here, and what are we going to do is we are going to accept that animal object, and we are going to simply write the body now. So let's imagine this time we say set timeout, and again a callback is required. So we again going to use fat arrow. All right, and this time instead of 1 second, we are going to execute this callback function within 2 seconds. All right, so all we are going to do is animal dot push. Okay, and we are going to push this animal. Simple, that's all we are going to do. Okay, now let's invoke this function, and we say post animal. Let's pass in that object, and the object would be, let's say, let me use this. So we say type is herbivorous, and let's say example is goat. Okay, so I'm saving this, and I have to now call the get animals. Okay, so let's execute the get animals, and let's see whether we see anything onto the screen or not. Okay, so what we see is the initial values. However, the animal that we have added in here is not being added, so we don't see the goat animal in the list, right? Because the DOM was rendered right first, and it picked these two values. Because the response was returned after the DOM is rendered, so you don't see it here. So how can we fix that? So now to fix that, we have to make a little change in this function. We are going to pass in a callback function, and right after the animal is pushed to this array, we are going to call this callback function. Okay, so this is the first change. So now we have to provide in the animal in get animals object in here. Okay, and now we don't require this. If we do the save, you see it is taking some time to load, and now all the three animals are being added. Okay, so that's the callback function into JavaScript. Now in ES6, I guess, this promises were introduced, and they have kind of simplified this callback. So we are now going to see how can I convert this callback function into a promise. So I'm going to take a copy of this code, okay, and I'm going to paste it here. And let me do one more thing. Let me comment out this, and let us use the promise now. So let me save that, and we go to promise. Okay, and let's start making some promise. So the data will remain as it is, this get animal will remain as it is, but herein we are going to make a change. Okay, so since we are not using callback, so I have to get rid of this, right? And I also remove this. Okay, and now what do we have to do? We have to say return new promise, and this promise accepts a callback, as you could see. and the callback has two arguments. So we are going to use those, resolve and reject. Okay, and let's pass in the fat arrow syntax in here. Let us copy this whole thing, put inside the promise, and got to do some changes in here. So we are going to say const error is equal to false. So we say if there is no error means the promise is resolved. Okay, we are going to invoke the resolve function. Okay, else the promises fail, and we are going to say reject, and we are going to pass in the message, and the message would be something went wrong. Okay, so that's how we are going to reject this. All right, rest all remain the same. Now how to invoke this? So we are going to say we are going to pass this animal, and the next thing is, in case of promises, you know, we got to use then once it's resolved, and we have to use catch when it's rejected. So we are going to say then, and here we are going to pass in, once the promise is resolved, call this method. If the promise is failed, right, since the promise is failed, so again this is going to accept the callback function. So we are going to receive the error in here, and all we are going to do is print the error. Okay, so let me save this and let us see. So you could see that all the values are printed, and if I change it to true, and if we do this, so in the console something went wrong. This is what we are going to see. If we don't have this catch block in place, right, and we run that, so we are going to see this uncaught error. All right, so catch is to catch those errors, and then is once the promise is resolved, what do you want to do? All right, so the last one is async and await, and for that let me again copy this promise and paste it in here. This has even simplified you know, the promises in JavaScript, how you are going to use that. So instead of this then and catch, let's see what we have to do. So we have to do in the await, what are we going to do? So let us comment this out and uncomment the await and this. So now nothing is being printed, if you could see. So I come here and I'm going to create a function async and function, and all I'm going to say, let's call it a function as main. Okay, and all you need to do now is, so you are going to say await, right, and you're going to say post animal. All right, and now you have to pass in the body. So let me copy this. This is the object that we want to post. So this is what we are going to do once this is done. All right, so the next thing that we have to do is we have to invoke this method now. So this will wait until this is done, and once this is done, this then it is going to call. And therefore, once we save that, we will see the data. Okay, I will not see because we have not called this. So yeah, sorry about that. Let me call this, and now it's invoked. We are using live servo. So hopefully it should have returned us the results. Let me check. Yeah, it's correct, it's commented, and we are working on async and await, so it should have worked. Let me check. So we have function that's correctly set, we have the promise which is also correctly set, and then we are using async function main, We are waiting for this function, and then we are executing the get animals, and then finally we are invoking main. What's wrong with this? So we have to change it to false and then it will show up. Copy paste error. So you could see that now this is, instead of using the then and catch, this is how you can use async and await. All right, so these are three ways you can do asynchronous coding into JavaScript. Thank you so much.